is Channel 2 News at Noon.
Good afternoon. There's another possible break in the World Trade Center bombing.
The FBI has moved in on a third suspect in connection with the disaster. Agents in the investigation arrested a man this morning in Maplewood, New Jersey. That's about 10 miles west of Jersey City, where the first suspect was arrested. The new suspect is expected to be arraigned this afternoon in Newark. That's where Channel 2's Chris Borgen joins us live with the latest on this breaking story. Chris?
Dana, what has happened here is the FBI has made a number of massive breaks in the case. Number one, they now have reason to believe they know the quantity of explosive materials used in the bomb. They believe that they know where the bomb may have been assembled. And now, with the arrest of this man, they think they have arrested a person who may very well have assisted in assembling that bomb. His name is Nidal Ayyad, and he apparently was one of the men allowed to go into and out of that 10-foot by 10-foot rented locker in the Commercial Space Station rental lockers on Mallory Avenue in Jersey City. The FBI now believe the bomb was assembled in that locker, which was allegedly leased by Mohammed Salami. On Friday, investigators searching the locker found some 300 pounds of explosive materials, including nitric and sulfuric acid and a quantity of nitroglycerin. Documents found in the locker established that the materials, over 1,600 pounds of it, had been purchased and paid for, not stolen. By subtracting the 300 pounds remaining in the locker from the original 1,600 pounds on the sales slips and invoices, investigators now believe the bomb placed in the Trade Center was a massive 1,300 pounds of explosives. Witnesses have reported seeing Salami and at least three other men, one now believed to have been Ayyad, repeatedly going into and out of that rented locker over a period of time, possibly, investigators say, to mix the materials and to assemble the explosive device. A portion of that device may have been taken to this house on Panrapo Street, where Salami lived for a short period of time. He moved out of the house just 2 days after the Trade Center bombing. A police search of the apartment uncovered a pattern of nitric acid stains on the walls, indicating that some of the explosive materials may have been destabilized and exploded. The FBI has now issued subpoenas to the Jersey City Medical Center asking for records of anyone asking for or receiving treatment for nitric acid burns. As of this moment, Ayyad has been brought to the federal courthouse here in Newark, New Jersey, where he is going through a processing period, awaiting arraignment before a federal magistrate sometime later today. One small bit of miscellaneous information, but very important. It turns out that Mr. Ayyad may very well have been employed by a very large chemical firm in the area. Live in Jersey City, and rather live in Newark as of this moment, I'm Chris Borgen. Back to you in studio, Lisa.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. And there's more on this story. Workers today are reaching deeper into the cavernous bomb site at the World Trade Center. They drilled a large hole through the plaza above the crater. And this morning, that huge 25-ton crane finally began lifting out tons of debris. One person at least is still missing, Wilfredo Mercado, a Vista Hotel employee. It's believed he was working near the bomb site at the time.